care after low back spine surgery is very important. If you have underwent spine surgery recently, or if you are planning to undergo a low back spine surgery, this video is for you. I'm Dr. Kalyan from Hyderabad. I'm a neurosurgeon and spine surgeon with more than 10 years of experience, and have an experience of operating upon more than 4,000 patients. In this video, I will try to answer the common questions asked by my patients. So the first question, which you need to know, how is the wound bandaged? So immediately after surgery, your wound will be covered with the sterile bandages. Normally, this first bandage will be removed the day after surgery. The surgeon or the nurse will examine your wound to be sure that it looks as expected. Depending on the type of closure you have had and your surgeon's preference, another bandage may be applied. But do not be concerned if no bandage is reapplied. Once again, your surgeon will determine whether you require a second bandage or not. How do I take care of my wound at home? I prefer my patients' surgical wounds to be covered with a sterile bandage. I advise them to have it changed either daily or on alternate days by a trained nurse. And the most important is daily inspection of the wound. So what is daily inspection? Daily or on alternate days, whenever the dressing is changed, the trained nurse monitors the wound for any redness, any discharge or soakage of the wound, any blackening of the wound edges, water-like fluid discharge from the wound, fullness of the wound, or fever. It is normal to have some fullness in your wound after spine surgery. This is a result of swelling, because of the swelling of the tissues around, and sometimes because of accumulation of the blood. This accumulated blood is called an hematoma. This is a normal occurrence, and it is usually a very small amount and usually gets absorbed within the body. But in the rare cases, if it increases progressively in size, immediately report to the surgeon. And also, if you find any of the signs which I have listed just before, I want to list them again. Any redness, discharge or soakage of the wound, blackening of the wound edges, or water-like fluid discharge from the wound, or fullness of the wound or fever, immediately report to your surgeon. Next common question is, can the patient take bath before the sutures are removed? For my patients, the bathing is allowed, but what is not advisable is to let the surgical wound get wet. So the patient can take bath, but you will have to keep the surgical wound dry. Patient can take a sponge bath without letting the wound get wet, or if the patient wants to take a shower, he can cover the wound with water resistant dressings. Contact your surgeon. He will explain you, even he will give you options regarding the water resistant dressings. How long does it take for the wound to heal? Your wound will be healed within 2 weeks after your surgery, unless there is some reason for delay in wound healing. People who have other medical problems such as diabetes, people who are taking steroids for any other condition, those with an immunocompromised system, they may require additional time for the wounds to heal completely. Is it normal for the wound to itch? Some of my patients complain of itching around the wound. Mild itching is common. But significant itching may be because of intolerance of the patient's skin to the surgical tapes, or maybe because of infection. So if the itching is significant, consult your surgeon. He will check your wound for infection. He may change the surgical tapes, or in some cases, he may advise you not to use the bandages further. He may also advise you some oral medications and topical creams to make itching tolerable. When are the sutures removed? This depends upon a number of factors like type of surgery, complexity and duration of surgery, nature of your skin, associated comorbids like diabetes, steroid use, your immunity status, age of the patient. But grossly, usually staples are removed 7 to 14 days after the spine surgery. The duration of removal is decided by your surgeon. Sometimes absorbable sutures are used, which don't require any removal. Is it painful to have sutures and staples removed? Calm down. Your major ordeal is done. Most of my patients are apprehensive if removal of the sutures or staples is painful. The answer is usually no. Removal of sutures usually causes mild discomfort and some pain. It is very unusual to cause severe or unbearable pain. So don't be hesitant, don't be apprehensive. The removal of sutures is a small process and it will be done with ease. How much time will it take for the suture removal? Obviously, it depends upon the length of the surgical wound. The longer the incision, it will take a longer time. But in majority of cases, the sutures will be removed within 5 to 10 minutes. And as I've said before, it rarely causes significant pain. Next question. Now your sutures are removed. When can you take bath after the suture removal? Here the advice depends upon your surgeon's preference, the kind of surgery you underwent, and the healing status of the wound. But for majority of my patients, once the sutures are removed and I confirm that the wound is healthy, I advise them to cover the wound with a sterile bandage for 3 to 4 days. I advise them to avoid wetting the wound for a week. Then they can take a sponge bath and during bath can clean the wound with clean water 3 to 4 days after the suture removal. And after 1 week, they can take a normal shower. Hope all of you have a fantastic and quick recovery. My sincere advice, be in regular touch with your surgeon. If you have any doubts regarding wound care, do not hesitate to ask your surgeon. All the things which I have told before are general guidelines. As I have told repeatedly, each patient is unique. His surgery is unique. His skin condition is unique. So the best who can advise you is the surgeon who has operated upon you. So before following my advice, compulsorily contact your surgeon to make any changes in the advice he has given you. And you have to follow your surgeon at any cost. I'm a brain and spine surgeon with extensive experience. If you have any query, you can contact me on the given number. If you are a healthcare professional, physiotherapist, or if you are interested in a coordinated teamwork, do not hesitate to contact me on the number given. Kindly share this video with your friends or colleagues or relatives who have underwent a spine surgery or planning to undergo a spine surgery. I'll be explaining you in detail a number of brain and spine conditions like brain tumors, spine tumors, head injury, spinal cord injury, slip disc in my future videos. Kindly subscribe to my channel for quick updates.